Hey guys, what's up? Spider-Man 96 here. So today I thought we'd have a look way back to 2002, have a nice throwback to Toy Biz, Series 1 of Marvel Legends. Some gems here. Let's take a look. Let's go.
Now dig on this.
Back to the start. So yeah, I mean, with Toy Biz, they had a success with the Spider-Man Classics range, so they decided to move on. Avi Arad, who owned part of Toy Biz, he came in and brought out the Marvel Legends, which we all know and love today. It's produced by Hasbro, but back then it was produced by Toy Biz. We were given One Wave to begin with. We were given Captain America, the Incredible Hulk, several versions of Iron Man, which I'll get into in a bit, and Toad, which is the only one I never picked up back then because I was a kid and I wasn't really interested in Toad. One of my biggest regrets as a collector today. But yeah, the wave was pretty good. Let's take a look at each individual figure and just have a talk about some of the differences to what we get today. So yeah, without further ado, let's have a look at the Star-Spangled Man, Captain America. So yeah, here we go. I mean, this is what I'd probably consider to be the quintessential classic Captain America look. We've got the feathered wings on the top. We've got a pretty good likeness. We've got a pretty solid figure for back in the time. You know, Toy Biz were obviously then come up with some experience. The shield itself is not anywhere near the standard we kind of see today, but for the time, it's quite cool. We get two elastic parts on there. It's quite fragile because of the age of the plastic, so I need to be quite careful with it. So yeah, it's just gonna move that really gently. And yeah, I mean, we'll have a look at that in a minute. Cap himself, there's a little bit of discoloration now on the face, as you can see. We get a full 360 at the head, which is connected to the neck. We get an ab crunch of sorts, it's on a rotation joint as well. It's kind of a bit odd. We do go up a nice 90 degree angle. The fingers do raise and lower as a separate joint. We also get a wrist rotation and, an arm rotation. The cuff of the glove. There's a ball joint, pretty standard for everything there. All these Toy Biz figures had a weird kind of articulation. I feel like there's a piece of rubber in there holding everything together. I feel like I know that because I broke one apart once. So yeah, then the legs, we do get a good range of legs. We get a nice 90 degree out. We get a kind of backwards one that goes to an angle still, which is fine. And we do get a nice range of motion going forward. And then on the bottom, we do get a nice rotation at the thigh. We get a double jointed knee, which is awesome. And we get boot cuff rotation. We also get a ankle movement and we get a toe articulation as well. So all in all, I think for the time, if you remember being around back then, like, and collecting, this was quite a huge thing because several years before this, we only got really some quite standard 5 points articulation figures. And as you can see, I'm just putting the shield on there. It does attach to the back. It does look a bit weird, but it was nice to have that display option. There's something more than we get today instead of just pulling it in the back. It'd be nice to get that kind of look. I think this cap figure is pretty solid. I think even now, like, it's pretty good, but obviously doesn't quite show up to the display. So yeah, let's have a look at the base. So basically, Toy Biz figures had this amazing thing where they'd all come with a display option of a base, which is something we definitely don't get anymore. Some people loved it, some people weren't too fond of it because some of the bases were about scale and they were, you know, you like to have your collection displayed together and it didn't really work that way with these. We've got a weird tank on there, which obviously isn't to scale with a figure, but it's still nice to have that option. But the base itself, I mean, it does look kind of cool with the figure on it. It's just, I don't think Toy Biz have quite mastered the scale of walls and things like that and brickwork. But nevertheless, it was a nice option to get it. And I think this figure is still a pretty solid addition to my collection. before I go into the next figure, this is a very quick look at Toad, which is the figure I never picked up. I will probably pick him up one day, but he does go for a lot on eBay, so it's finding him quite cheap. But yeah, just thought you'd appreciate this. Have a very good look at that. So yeah, now we get our Iron Man. This is a classic Tony Stark Iron Man. I think the figure itself, again, is pretty cool. We've got obviously a few updated versions of these, not quite as bulky, a bit more streamlined figures. It's got the 80th anniversary figure, which is obviously the same suit, which kind of just taken over this one for me. But this is in my collection on my Avengers display for many, many years, and I've had it for a long time. We've got two other variants of this, which we'll go into in a minute. But in terms of articulation, we do get a good range of motion on everything. Similar to the Cap figure, we do get very similar articulation. With this, we do get, I feel like it's a little bit less stiff, and we do get a nice butterfly joint on the back there. We get double jointed knee. We do get some calf rotation. We do, yeah, that's the butterfly joint. So that's revolutionary, because we've got that, gives you just that extra bit of motion. But it does leave that hollow, gaping hole in the back. Thighs rotate quite nicely, a little bit stiff because of the age of the figure. And then again, the calf. So yeah, I think the figure itself is pretty damn decent. We also get this removable face part, face piece for the mask, for the helmet, sorry. And I think that's, you know, that Tony Stark head sculpt is incredible. It really does look like, especially Tony Stark from the kind of Demon in the Bottle era, that art, it just looks so bang on. And I think it's just a really nice looking toy. Definitely a lot of care gone into that in preparation. This is one of the variants that I did pick up a few years back. This is the same costume, but we do get the horny mask. Obviously that's not the right way to call it, but that's the best way. You get two horns going up and you get it, you get what I'm saying. So yeah, I mean, this one is, I still prefer the classic, but I do like the gold. The classic one is still my favorite of the wave, because it just screams nostalgia to me, because obviously I had that for a long time. But this does look nice. It's a nice paint job. The other variant we got was Stealth Iron Man, which we've seen with various figures they've done that with. Nothing really new to say there. It's just blue with a red chest, with a red arc reactor. Yeah, it looks okay, but I just never really felt the need to pick it up. The base for the Iron Man is less exciting than the Captain America one. I think I don't even tell you what it is. You do get some nice writing on it and a little bit of thing. I don't know, is it meant to be the Stark Tower in the background? If it is, it looks really odd. Is it meant to be some kind of float? I don't know. I'm guessing it's meant to be the building, but it's never really been something I've chosen to display the figures with. I think it just looks a little bit odd. But otherwise, I love this figure. You know, it still holds a dear place in my heart. And of course, we get the Incredible Hulk, which is, again, has not probably aged the best, but at the time was incredible. For a bigger figure to have this kind of articulation, this kind of movement, it does look really good. And he's a hefty, big dude as well. The articulation is great for some of this size, and also we do get some really incredible, and that face is like terrifying. That's the whole 360 on the head. And the thing is, I love the fact that we get this ab crunch. It's actually better than the ones, the smaller figures I've just shown. A lot of these joints are very stiff. You see, I really can't move that without causing damage, so I'm not going to. But we do get the thigh rotation. We get a single jointed knee. We do get a good range of movement on the foot. We get ankle rocker and ankle pivot. All in all, I think it's obviously we get a lot more range of motion with the Hasbro Deluxe figures and the Builder figures, but this is still pretty cool for its day. You get that big butterfly joint again. Again, I'm not too fussed by that big gaping hole, but I understand why they've done it. It's So you can get Hulk in some pretty cool poses. Does look pretty good for the day. He's my only comic book Hulk in the collection, so I do need to update him. But he's been on my Avengers shelf for a long, long time. And he does tower over the other figures. Again, not as much as the best today, but the reason I get so excited about this is because back then, the bigger figures were very, very low in articulation. You know, we got some Venoms with the Spider-Man Classics, it didn't look right. So we've got this really, really bulky dude. Hasbro, you know, don't seem to get the deco the same as this. You know, we've got some really good paint apps on there as well. Do get a base with this guy. Basically, this base was, I think we've seen it a few times. I think it came with the Series 6 Juggernaut, to my knowledge, as well. It's nothing really that exciting. It's just a broken down wall. So yeah, I think it looks okay. But you know, you can get Hulk in some poses, smashing through that, which looks pretty cool as well. So yeah, that's kind of the wave, I guess. That's the last part. That is the Incredible Hulk. So guys, that is the origins of Marvel Legends. This is the first wave. Really hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and tap the bell icon so you can be up there on all future videos. But yeah, thanks so much, guys. Take care. Have a good week. Bye.